So yes, we observe many changes on our earth. Okay, as you have told that you are facing weather changes, changes in such as sunrise, sunset, raining. Okay, and the plants are growing, trees are growing. So various changes. So this is some of the changes. So many more changes we will study in this chapter about the earth. So first, in previous chapter, you may have study about the lithosphere. So who can tell me the, what do you mean by lithosphere? Yes, what do you mean by lithosphere? Anji? Yes, beta? Yes, Harji? What do you mean by lithosphere? Anji?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, lithosphere means in which the buses, cars, land comes.
In which we include star. Please repeat.
Ma'am, it includes the buses, cars, lands, plants.
Land we can include, but buses, cars. Okay. Yes, Rishita. Hanji beta?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, lithosphere is the solid crust or the hard top of the earth. It is made up of rocks and minerals covered by a thin layer of soil.
Yes. So, crust is the upper part of earth surface. Okay? If you have studied in previous chapter, so you have studied various layers of the earth. You have studied various layers. Okay? Such as this is inside. So what is the inside? It is core, hai na? Then outer, it is crust, and in between it is mantle. Okay, so these three layers of earth you have under. And where is the lithosphere? In which portion of these layer is the lithosphere? Yes, on which portion there is lithosphere? Yes, Bhavya.
And crust.
Yes, on the crust part. So here is lithosphere. So then you may have studied about this lithosphere crust, that there is oceanic crust also and there is continental crust also. Okay, so such as this is continents and these are oceans. Okay, so here on the oceans, this is the crust. Yes, so whether all it is visible to all. This is oceanic crust, okay, where below the oceans and below the continents, there is continental crust. And this is all crust area. And this is also called lithosphere. Okay, so this lithosphere is divided into various plates. So you can say there are cracks in between. You can say like this, that here are some cracks in between these lithosphere or crust. So that is called the lithospheric plates. Okay, so here you can see, here there is below, here is mantle, and then there is core. And what is in the core of our earth? Yes, what is in the core of our earth? Kya hai bachche? In the core. What is here in the core? Yes. Inner. Yes, inner. Core area. Yes, lava. When it comes out, it becomes lava. But when it inside, it is magma, molten magma. Okay? So in the core here, it is molten magma. Okay? So So here are various cracks you can see in these lithospheric plates. Okay? And these lithospheric plates, they are moving. Okay? You will be surprised to know that these lithospheric plates are moving. There may be very small, small gaps. Okay? Very small, small gaps. Otherwise, this diagram is very small. Our Earth is too large. So this small gap showing here may be large in reality. Okay? So there are small gaps in between these plates. And these plates keep on moving. And these plates keep on moving just a few millimeter every year. Okay? These lithospheric plates. These lithospheric plates. These keep on moving just a few millimeter every year. Okay, every year. So just a few millimeters. You can see that there are how many millimeters are there in 1 centimeter? In 1 centimeter, how many millimeters are there? Yes, beta? Yes, 10. So just a few millimeters, these plates move. So very slowly, take thousands of years even to move 1 centimeter. Okay? So it means ki these lithospheric plates, so there is movement in these lithospheric plates. So these lithospheric plates, they are if we say lithosphere, it is broken into a number of plates, our lithosphere, okay? It is broken into a number of plates. And these are called lithospheric plates. And they are moving very slowly, just a few millimeters each year. Why this is so? This is because of the movement of molten magma inside the earth. Okay? Why this is so? This is because of the movement of molten magma. So as you see, here is molten magma. So this molten magma keeps on moving in the circular motion. Okay? This keeps on moving in the circular motion. So here you can do one activity. Okay? Today you will do this activity and tomorrow you will let me know what you have observed. This is also activity shown on your this page. Here is the activity. So what you will do, you will take a container. You will fill it, this container with water and keep a lid on it. Don't use pressure cooker, okay? Use that container, keep a lid on it. On that lid, you can keep some peas, beads or spoon. You can keep, okay? And after keeping, then you will observe okay, when the water is boiling, then lid will begin to shake. Okay, when the water is boiling, then lid will begin to shake and the things that you have kept on the lid, they will maybe fell down or what will happen, you will tell me. Okay, they will start moving. The same is the condition with these lithospheric plates. Here is in the molten magma. As you see, water is boiling. The same molten magma, it is moving in circular motion. Okay, it is moving in circular motion and this molten magma, it causes these lithospheric plates to move. So you can make this diagram roughly in your notes for understanding. Okay? You can make these diagram for your understanding. Ye sirf understanding ke liye banana hai. Otherwise, the diagram from this book that you have to make, that is of volcano. Okay? Volcano and earthquake. So this you can draw for your understanding. Yes, Akriti, the activity is clear. Hanji, Akriti.
Ma'am, may you repeat the which activity we will learn at home?
Activity, beta, that is given on the second activity. Second activity, hai, take a container, fill it with water, then keep a lid. Okay? On the page of volcano. Wahan pe volcano draw hai na, uske saath hai. Clear?
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Very good. So you have to do this activity, okay? Any other query till now? So due to the movement of this molten magma inside the earth, these plates, they are moving very slowly, as you will do today's activity. When the water is boiling, the lid will shake and the things, okay, they can fall down. So what will happen, that you will tell me. So this molten magma, it moves in a circular motion and it causes the lithospheric plates to move, and they just moving few millimeters every year. So these movement of these lithospheric plates and these circular motion of molten magma, it caused changes on the earth. Okay, as we have discussed, we experience many changes, but there are some changes that we don't see. Okay, we don't observe. Hum observe nahi karte, but they changes, they are occurring on earth. Wo changes ho rahe hain. So these movement. So this is movement inside the earth. Ye movement kahan pe ho rahi hai? This movements, these forces, they are working inside the earth, and outside the earth, many forces are working. So the work forces which are working inside the earth, the earth movement. So ye kya hai? Movement. There is some movement here, and there is movement outside also. Okay. So we will discuss in detail in this chapter. So the earth movement, we divide into two parts. Earth movements. So earth movements are divided into two parts. One is exogenic and second endogenic. So what is exogenic and what is endogenic? Exo means outer, endo means inner, genic means origin. Okay, so whatever forces that are working outer on the surface, they are exogenic, and the forces which are working interior of the earth, they are endogenic. Clear? So these earth movements are divided on the basis of these forces. So the forces that occur in interior of earth, they are, which forces are those? Endogenic. Okay, and the forces which act on the surface of earth, they are exogenic. जो बाहर बाहर अर्थ के सरफेस करे, बिकॉज हेयर वी आर लिविंग ऑन द अर्थ. ठीक है, ऑन द आउट ऑन दिस लिथोस्फेयर वी आर लिविंग. सो द अर्थ इज मूविंग जस्ट अ फ्यू मिलीमीटर, वी आर नॉट ऑब्जर्विंग. ठीक है, सो दीज आर द चेंजेस. दीज आर एक्सोजेनिक एंड एंडोजेनिक फोर्सेस. एंडोजेनिक इन द इंटीरियर एंड एक्सोजेनिक इन द आउटर ऑन द सर्फेस, यू कैन से अर्थ. दिस इज क्लियर? वट इज एंडोजेनिक, वट इज एक्सोजेनिक? Clear? So sometimes these endogenic forces, endogenic which are working in the interior of earth, so sometimes these endogenic forces provide sudden movements. We have discussed there are some cracks. So sometimes this movement, there are some cracks, and this molten magma can come out from through these cracks. There is molten magma and there are some cracks, and through these cracks sometime this molten magma come out in the form of volcano, and sometimes it causes earthquake. ठीक है, यही जो lithosphere plates की movement है, sometime जो sudden, अब these changes, the movement of lithosphere, it is very slow change. ठीक है, these changes are very slow, but sometimes these endogenic forces produced sudden movement. अब वो sudden movements कौन सी होती हैं? Sudden movements, they are earthquake or volcano. So just this molten magma comes out here in the form of volcano. तो ये क्या हो जाएगा? Volcano. This you can draw roughly for your understanding. ठीक है? So यहाँ से अगर cracks में से कुछ आ गया तो वो क्या हो गया? Volcano. ठीक है? It can be here or it can be any other place also. So these are sudden movements. So endogenic forces can cause slow movement and can cause the sudden movement also. So there are various exogenic and endogenic forces, okay, that we will discuss in this chapter. So what are the, first we will talk about the endogenic forces. Okay, endogenic forces mein in your diagram that is shown in your book, there are sudden forces, ठीक है, and there are diastrophic forces, ठीक है. First, if we talk about sudden forces, sudden जो forces हैं, what are they? अब sudden कैसे हो सकते हैं? Such as earthquake, volcano and landslide. Landslide कहाँ पे होता है? Landslide occurs in mainly mountainous areas, ठीक है. Earthquake हो गया, volcano and then landslide. So these are sudden forces, ठीक है. ये sudden एकदम से forces they occur, but some forces they are diastrophic, ठीक है. Diastrophic. Diastrophic means very slowly. So these forces are very slowly, diastrophic forces. और वो कैसी है? They are building mountains. Mountains जो बन रही हैं, if you have studied the Himalayas, they are also gaining height just a few millimeter every year. ठीक है? तो उसकी height क्यों बढ़ रही है? Because of these movements of plates. When these plates coincide, so their mountains are formed. So that is why the height of Himalayas is also increasing. ठीक है? वो कैसे increase हो रही है? Very slowly. We are not just observing. हम observe नहीं कर रहे. ठीक है? So जो diastrophic forces होती है वो कहते हैं जैसे बिल्डिंग ऑफ माउंटेन्स. ठीक है, बिल्डिंग माउंटेन्स. सो दीज आर एक्सोजेनिक फोर्सेस. एक्सोजेनिक फोर्सेस इंक्लूड सडन फोर्सेस ऑल्सो एंड डायस्ट्रोफिक फोर्सेस ऑल्सो. सडन फोर्सेस आर क्विक एंड डायस्ट्रोफिक स्लो चेंजेस. ठीक है, देन कम्स टू द एंड सॉरी दीज आर एंडोजेनिक फोर्सेस, है ना. तो यहाँ पे ये चेंज कर लेना. दीज आर एंडोजेनिक फोर्सेस एंड दीज आर एक्सोजेनिक. ठीक है, ये हमने एंडोजेनिक किए ना. दीज ऑल आर बिकॉज टू द इंटीरियर चेंजेस. द फोर्सेस विच आर एक्टिंग इन इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ, दिस इज सच एज वॉल्केनो वन ऑफ द फोर्सेस. ठीक है, दिस वी विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल. क्लियर. एंड नाउ कम्स द एक्सोजेनिक. एक्सोजेनिक this we will also discuss in detail. Exogenic, it includes erosion, deposition, ठीक है, erosional and depositional. So this we will discuss, erosional and depositional. Erosion with the wind, water, then wind or water carries the sand or soil with it, erosed from one place, deposited other, ठीक है. So which forces occur, which are the forces that are responsible? Wind, water, sea waves and glaciers, we will discuss. ठीक है, this table you can also draw in your notebooks. ठीक है, otherwise it is drawn in your books, so you can learn from there also. ठीक है, wind, water, ठीक है, wind, water, glaciers and sea waves. ठीक है, so all these are various forces which are responsible for changing in our earth. ठीक है, till now the concept is clear. What are lithospheric plates? ठीक है, what cause movement or why these lithospheric plates are moving? What is the reason of moving of these plates? What are endogenic forces? What are exogenic forces? All these concepts are clear. If there is any doubt, please let me know. Okay. Yes, Rishita, can you explain about the why lithospheric plates are moving? Yes, Rishita, please, Vijay, explain why these lithospheric plates.
Yes, ma'am.
Are on moving.
Yes, ma'am. These plates move around very slowly. This is because of the movement of the molten magma inside the earth.
Yes, this is also one of the questions from your back exercise also. Okay? Ki why these plates are moving? Yes. So these are moving because of the molten magma inside the earth. Okay? And this molten magma moves in the circular motion in the earth. Okay, so what are endogenic forces? Yes, what are endogenic forces? We are discussing questions answer also side by side. ठीक है? Yes, what are endogenic and exogenic forces? Yes, Bhavya. हाँ जी.
endogenic forces are the endogenic forces are the seven movements that occurs in the earth, like earthquake and volcanoes.
Yes, these are the sudden forces. But what are endogenic
sudden forces?
What is the definition of endogenic forces? If you have to tell, explain what are endogenic forces?
Yes, the forces Mani, which occur inside the earth.
Yes, the forces which act in interior of the earth. Okay, which are working or which are forcing changes in the interior of earth. Yes, Bani. Hanji.
Yes, ma'am. The forces which act in the interior of the earth are called endogenic forces.
Okay. In the interior of the earth, they are endogenic, and what are exogenic? Yes.
That work on the surface of the earth.
Yes, the forces which act on surface of earth, they are exogenic forces. And if you have to, if you are called, what are the various forces? So you can tell these forces also. Okay. Otherwise, if just meaning, so then you have to explain the definition only. Okay, so any doubt till now? Yes, Rishita, Bhavya, Vani, you have raised answer for this question only, or for your doubt? Hanji, Rishita. Okay. So now next is about the volcano. So then you will draw the diagram of volcano. So volcano, in volcano there is a vent. In volcano, there is a vent in earth crust. This is earth crust, and there is a vent opening, or that opening, from that opening which molten magma, it erupts suddenly. ठीक है वो molten magma. तो ये तो सिर्फ समझाने के लिए बनाया. Otherwise you have to draw the only diagram of volcano differently. उसका differently बनाना है आपको. ठीक है. So this volcano, what is volcano? Volcano is a vent in earth crust. Volcano क्या है? It is a vent. ये earth crust है. Earth की crust में it is just a vent through which the molten magma or that erupt, it comes out suddenly. ठीक है? So that is volcano. That diagram you will draw. So this is volcano. So there is opening inside. ठीक है? So this you can draw, then you can tell me, explain here what is this is when the outside the come that come outside, then it becomes lava, then inside it is magma. Okay, so here you can draw the diagram. So this is like this, you can diagram here. It is a vent. Okay, vent hai jisme ki ye magma it comes out. ठीक है, देन यू कैन एक्सप्लेन हियर इट इज द मैग्मा चैम्बर. ठीक है, दिस इज डायग्राम ड्रॉन, सो यू मे ड्रॉ दिस डायग्राम. ठीक है, ऑफ वॉल्केनो. सो देन विद दिस लावा देयर गैसेस एंड ऐश इट आल्सो कम्स, गैसेस एंड ऐश इट आल्सो कम्स विद द लावा. सो दैट मोल्टन मैग्मा व्हेन इट कम्स आउट इट बिकम्स लावा. ठीक है, सो दिस इज वेंट. ये जो प्रॉपर आ रहा है बाहर, ये क्या है? वेंट है. ठीक है, थ्रू विच द मैग्मा इज कमिंग आउट, दिस इज वेंट. सो आर यू ड्रॉइंग द डायग्राम साइड बाय साइड? शो मी योर नोटबुक्स वेयर यू हैव ड्रॉन ऑल दिस व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. सो यू कैन राइट हियर इट इज द क्रस्ट. ठीक है, ऑल द डिटेल्स. Yes, show me your notebooks, what you have drawn, or where you have noted the points today. Yes, be quick, beta. Hanji, Akriti, show me your notebook, beta. Where you have written the points or draw the diagram. Yes, rest of the student. Hanji. Anji, Akriti and Bhavya, I'm waiting. यस गुड भव्या. हां जी आकृति. यस बच्चे यू हैव नॉट रिटन द पॉइंट्स और ड्रॉन द आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट यू कैन ड्रॉ दिस फॉर रफ रिवीजन दैट वेयर यू आर मेकिंग नोट्स यू कैन राइट हियर रफ. यस द टाइमिंग इज ओवर बच्चे वीक वीक शो. सो ओनली भव्या वाज एक्चुअली प्रेजेंट इन माई क्लास है ना भव्या आकृति. So whatever if you have written the points, you can just show me, note the diagram. Anji Suhana? Yes, Rishita, very good. Yes. Okay, Rishita, you have underlined on book. Okay, good. So go through the topic. Okay? Go through the topic, draw the diagram, and we will continue this topic tomorrow.